Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry. It's Wednesday and I had a volunteer catering event on Saturday and it's still a hot mess. And I'll explain in a little while what happened, but I thought since I'm going to reset my kitchen, why don't I film this? And if you need to reset your kitchen, we can do this together. Okay, so first of all, sorry I don't have my gimbal, so if it's a little bit shaky, I apologize. My husband's using it to film videos right now in his Pilates studio. By the way, he does have a new channel. I'll link it below. So the first thing I'm gonna do is show you, kind of get an assessment of the mess, and then I'll tell you my little story. So like I said, I do volunteer catering events, especially for my church or people in my church. And my friend had a memorial celebration of life for his mom. So I volunteered to cater that. So I used my couple chafing dishes here. Luckily, my husband did load and unload my car to transport all the stuff and the food to the venue, which was a church. Okay, so you can see here I had the two chafing dishes. I have some water, lemonade, gloves, cups. Okay, and then you walk in here. Oh, that's Zoe. Hi, Zoe. To the left is my family room, and that's kind of decent. I mean, this is basically what it looks like. I'd love to get rid of some books, but anyway, we did get rid of the rug, and I am in the market deciding if I should get a new rug or not. Here, this is Zoe's room. That's our beverage cooler for guests. I like to stock that up, so I need to do some of that, so I'm assessing here. Here to the right, I have some more lemonade. And my boss doesn't live in my state. And so I see him about twice a year, sometimes four, up to four times a year. He was over and he saw my other colleague who lives in another country, and she gave me a little care package. So I need to put that away. Over there is to my living room, dining room. Okay, my toaster oven, my Achilles heel. I don't like cleaning my toaster oven, so I may not do that today. Okay, here is my kitchen area. So yes, it has been hard to kind of cook here because I need to clean my kitchen. So you can see here, I did some of the washing already. Oh, I tell you, I was tired, okay? And here's the sink, some more of the catering stuff in there. And trust me, I was debating whether to film this or not because I do need energy, one, to clean all this stuff, and then I do need more energy to film it because it, you know, sometimes it doubles the time just to film. But here's some more shaping stuff, but I thought, hey, listen, this happens. Like every catering event, my kitchen becomes a hot mess, but I usually get it all cleaned up either that night or the next day. Most of the time it's the next day because I do need time to rest, because you're talking about like I am chopping, I'm cooking, I'm bringing everything there, doing the event, putting everything back in the car and coming back. And most of the time I do have volunteers. This last time there were a lot of great volunteers, so that was very helpful. My husband did load most of the car and unload, so that's very helpful. But I did a lot of chopping, and because it was a taco bar. So here's some more of that catering stuff. You see the beverage dispensers there. And then I have my little igloo here, which there are some drinks. So I need to put that away, most likely here. That's our recycling. And then I need to fix this up a little bit in order to put all those drinks. I was chopping potatoes for, and those need to go back where they belong. And then here is the counter. My orchid has died, which normally happens, and I keep telling myself I can make this orchid bloom, but who knows? So I'm keeping that for a while, and then so this is our counter. And by the way, this I have to put away too. We went on a hike with friends from out of the country. That's been sitting there for 10 days. So let's go back here. What I usually do is, after assessing the space, I like to go from one end of the room to the other. So since there's stuff overflowing here, I'll start with this space, because then, you know, if I kind of take one section at a time, and so it feels like I accomplished something. These will go in the garage. Most of this will go in the garage. I'm going to put this water and lemonade in my water storage. And since we're in Phoenix, my extra water, my prepper water, is in this closet here in the guest room. And there it is for now. I do have some under the water, under the bed also. And there's some there. So I'll just probably put it over here. And yes, I have this from my mom's house. I'm keeping that because I have some cassette tapes that I want to listen to. And so that's the project way in the future. This is our guest room. I do need to put a desk there. And while I was preparing for this event, a lot of the food that I had purchased and stuff like that, and drinks, I had put here in the guest room. So it's just kind of, you know, just extra space to put stuff. So I do have to clean this up a little bit there too. I do have, I think, a couple things in the mini fridge. So this is my guest room. Yeah, and by the way, that Friday night, right? So the event was Saturday morning. And that Friday night, we have once a month a Bible study group that comes here to our house. So I had there were 15 of us here. So I ended up just buying food for that. But I had to clean up after. And of course people help. But while after that, a few of them stayed and we talked for, oh my gosh, till like 12:30 in the morning, which was fine because during that time I was chopping. So I got a lot of chopping done and then went to bed, I'd say by 1, got up at 7. So I had about about 5 hours sleep because it took a little while to fall asleep. And I was up by 7 and I got home by 4. So that's how long it was. Sorry, this seems like a very long intro, but you could see how I walk through this space and assess. So I know I'm going to take care of that part first, go from one end of the room to the next. So things that I can put away, I'll start doing that. But let me tell you what happened. So sometime around 2 p.m., or no, 1:30 p.m. when the celebration of life was closing, I'm like, I am not feeling well. I think I'm going to pass out. And so it ended. I got up to go to the area where the food was. And on my way there, someone was like, hey, this coffee machine is not working. I went to go help them. And then I was like, you know what? I don't feel good. I need to lie down. And I had already told that to my other friend. And then I had told her who was doing the coffee thing. And then my other friend came by who I know. She goes like, look, I know a place to lie down, which was the nursery. And I tell you, it was just in the nick of time because I was about to pass out. And I normally don't eat till like 12 or 2. So that was like fine for me. But I think just the exhaustion of even like work in the last couple of weeks. And I'm sharing this because it was just crazy. And so I'm lying there in this nursery room and I start crying. And then my friend holds my hand and she's like, oh, are you crying because it's hard for you to accept other people serving you or something like that? And at first I was a little bit insulted, but then I thought, I see what she's saying because I serve a lot and you may be someone who serves a lot, right? And so anyway, I'm crying and I thought about it like through all the dizziness and I thought, no, I'm crying because I just don't want to be sick. I don't want to be lying here on the floor. You know, it's just like I didn't want to feel what I was feeling, right? And so anyway, she went and got me a bagel. She got some fruits. She found some Tylenol because I had a throbbing headache. And I normally don't get headaches. I used to get headaches every so often. Anyway, so I'm lying there. And then she's like, okay, it's no, you know, don't stress yourself out. You know, it's okay. And then I said, okay, you're right. There's no sense stressing out about this. Let me just pull myself together. And I was able to, thank goodness. So I took deep breaths, she got the food, and then we started eating, was having a little picnic. We were literally there for an hour. After I ate, I laid down again. And then another friend came in and we just had the best conversation. And so anyway, I was able to get home because at that time I was like, maybe someone can drive me. I can take Uber, someone can drive my car, whatever. I was coming up with all these solutions. That's when she said, you need to calm down and take a deep breath, right? So that's what I did. So I was able to drive myself home. It was around 4. My husband unloaded everything. And I'm telling you, I was exhausted. And then the next day, Sunday, I was at went to church, had lunch with my daughter, which is what we usually do. Since she's at university, we usually have lunch together on Sundays. Came home just still exhausted. And then Monday I worked, and I work from home, but I was just still feeling really tired and I couldn't get to this. My husband started cleaning up a little bit. Well, Monday I did do some of those dishes here, okay? But that was about it. Like, I had no more energy to put everything away. So that, then Tuesday I felt better, that was yesterday. And so today I was like, okay, I gotta get this done. So how long it will take, I don't know if this will be a full video or I'll break it into two parts. But anyway, let's get started by putting those chafing dishes away. I already washed this, so I'm gonna go ahead and put it with the chafing dish. Don't mind Zoe. We adopted her beginning of August, and I haven't filmed a video since she's been here, so she doesn't really know what's going on. So, but she is a Velcro dog, and she usually follows me everywhere. If you're wondering where I put everything, I actually have shelves in my garage specifically for events and catering stuff and platters, and like you saw, the chafing dishes and beverage dispenser. So that's where I'm putting them. Zoe, come on. All right, while I'm here in the guest room, I'm gonna go ahead and clean up here. I do have a mini fridge here in my guest bedroom. I do like to have, let's see, some ice, and I like to put ice cream in there for them, and that ensures for my mom when she comes over. I do have some food here, some sausages. I need to put in the big fridge. Yeah, because sometimes, like, I can use this fridge. Let's say I had some fresh mangoes or cut up mangoes, so I put it in there. So now that's all fixed. So I decided to go ahead and vacuum my guest room so that I could feel like this room is complete. I'm not gonna do the mopping till Thursday. Thursday is my floors day. That's when I vacuum and mop. So I'll leave that for Thursday, but I'm just gonna go ahead and vacuum this because there's a lot of foot traffic in here and lots of bags on the floor. And I do like to close the blinds because the sun comes in from that direction. All right, let's see what's in these bags. Okay, so these are the extra forks and spoons. Those go in a bin in the garage. This goes with my grocery bags. Gloves, those go actually in the laundry room. Ziploc, I'll refill my Ziploc drawer. This needs to be washed. And I'm not sure about this. This wasn't my box. They probably found the box there. Let me put the box with the recycling. How's your kitchen reset doing? Getting some motivation? Are you also resetting with me? Let me know in the comments. Okay, let's do the Ziploc next. And you can see how, you know, it takes time. So when I'm resetting after an event, I just take my time. I know, I'm sorry about the sink. I know, this is so gross too. I completely apologize. I'm telling you, that's real life. When you're kind of a little bit down for the count, things fall by the wayside. I'm trying to do this with one hand, but it will get reset. Okay, there you go. Okay, this is recycling. Hey Zoe, you doing okay? All right. This goes in my laundry room. My grocery bag holder is actually here on the table because I have another one here I need to put away. But these are from Bag Pods. I love these grocery bags. They're the best. Come with the best bag. You can access the bags from here. You can access the bags from on top. It cinches like that. There's also a carabiner to hook onto the shopping cart. I love this, and they hold a lot. So those are my grocery bags. All right, I went ahead and put the forks and spoons back in the bin in the garage where they belong. These are for the plates, so I still have to wash the plates. So put that in the kitchen for now. Hi, Zoe. I know. Okay, so these are the cups, and I'll go ahead and put them in the garage, but there might be more in the kitchen. We'll have to see. But that's pretty organized there. And I do label. Oh, these are not labeled, but anyway, I do kind of like see-through bins sometimes because you could see what's in it. Okay, excuse me, Zoe. All right, so these are for the tablecloths. These have to be washed. So I'm gonna go ahead and take them out, wash them. Oh, here's some more. Zoe wants attention. There's some more forks and spoons, so I'll put that away. Knives. I like these because they're compostable. Yeah. Napkins. I have a bin for the napkins also in the garage. I have a bin for the plates. I'll put those away. And yeah, all of these have to be washed. I feel like I didn't use, I didn't use these and the other purple one in there, so I don't have to wash those. Put that back. So when I do an event, definitely wash everything before putting it back. So let me go ahead and start the wash for this, for these. I'm going to go ahead and vacuum and mop this area since there's a lot of traffic bringing things in and out, loading, unloading. I'm gonna just use the Swiffer mop because it's just gonna be easier that way. And on Thursdays, that's when I'm gonna do the more deep cleaning of the floors. I usually like to use hot water, a little bit of dishwashing liquid, a little bit of bleach. So that's how I mop my tiles. And then as far as the vacuum, this is a Dyson V6 Animal. I love it. I've had it for years. I have had to change the battery twice. Now, the first battery I just got, both of them I got on Amazon, not a Dyson brand, you know, just something on Amazon, probably from China. And the second battery, the first battery was horrible. I mean, that was just, that drove me nuts because it barely worked. So I finally got a second battery because it finally went kaput, but this second battery is really great. I'm gonna go ahead and put the link for the Dyson V6, the battery, and also my Swiffer in the description below. Also, this cord goes to my garage freezer. I still have to do a video on that sometime, but my outlet went kaput in the garage. I tried to call two electricians from references and they never replied to me. So that was a little bit frustrating. So it's definitely a project I have to do, but for now, we almost forget that the electric cord is here. So it's working for now. Okay, friends, done with just this area, a little bit of the guest room vacuumed and mopped. So usually something like this probably is a half hour, but it's been like, I think an hour 15 of filming, because I just got to think of the different shots. But all the stuff that needs to be put in the garage are there. The tablecloths are in the washing machine, put away stuff, like I said, vacuumed and mopped. So let's move now. And like I said, that, you know, I go from one section to the next. So another way to think about it is what's the easiest, and maybe some of the thing that would be easier for this type of mess is putting things back where they belong. But I'm gonna go ahead and start with the beverage cooler, kind of where the dog area, beverage cooler, and then probably go to the kitchen table because a lot of that is putting stuff away. All right, let's move on to Zoe's area. These I'm gonna have to put in the beverage cooler, so I'm gonna go ahead and put them over here. For now, this is kind of the setup of what we have. When I eventually redo the kitchen, the dining room, which won't be for a few more years, I do want to have a beverage cooler, most likely here, built into the island area, and then this will go down, right? Because this was built in 96, and they love the higher countertop or the bar top for the kitchen island, which I'm just trying to be patient and be okay with it. And so this is the way it is. Here's a grocery bag, and I have some treats here. And I had these little containers because I was preparing Zoe's food, putting them in the fridge, so we just had to take them out and dump it into the bowl. But I found what's easier is that we just take her bowl, get some of the dry food, and then put some of the wet food in. And we were doing the wet food that's refrigerated, but I decided to go ahead and do the cans, and she likes them, and it's easier to store. So I have four left, so I definitely need more. And then this is her dry food. This is her leash for when she's in the car. This is her leash right now. And this was my previous dog's leash, and I'm just kind of hesitant to let it go because we might use it. I don't know. I do still feel a little bit sentimental about it. But anyway, that's that for now. And then her dog, her ball. So anyway, I bring this up because there would be more space in this bin if I took that away. I have been thinking about getting either one big basket or two similar baskets so it looks a little bit more visually okay to the eye. And then this is just a container, airtight. It's pretty good. I like that. That works for us. So as far as the system, it works. It's just more like the visual that I might change up. And I'm going to put this away in the bag pods that I had mentioned earlier. And you just stuff it in there. You don't have to fold it or anything. So it's really nice and easy. So that's that. And then as far as her blanket, I think I'm going to wash this now, put that in the laundry room. Okay, so let's deal with this basket. This is the snack basket for guests, and I can see that I have to get some more snacks. I went to the Mexican carniceria, got some chicharron, spicy and not spicy. I'm going to throw this away. And we had this for little small group gathering here, and I'm going to throw it away because we're not going to eat it. It's probably stale by now. And I literally dumped the potatoes in here because I needed space on the table. And so I'm going to put these away into the potato bin in my pantry. So I'll add that to my grocery list. I'm getting more individual snacks for here. Sometimes I put granola bars, Clif bars, chocolate, candy, chips, individual chips. So I like to do this because I want when someone comes to our home, they can always have some type of snack and some type of beverage. Okay, the reason I have all this LaCroix, I usually have a lot of LaCroix in here, but I hadn't put it away because I had mentioned last Friday, we have a Bible group discussion here in my house, and one of the guys, he always brings LaCroix, which I'm so grateful for. So I'm gonna go ahead and empty out the things here, like this fruit needs to go into, it's probably not good anymore, put it into the main fridge. I might try to consolidate the two lemonades. Okay, and I personally don't like bottled water in here, but I think Amazon had delivered something and gave us bottled water. We just don't like that. We have a Berkey, which we tried to have our guests use. But it worked out because when we had gone hiking, that's what we had given to our guests. It does remind me, I still have to take care of that camelback over there. So I'm just gonna go ahead and take this out. I'm gonna leave this on the one here on top. Those are more alcoholic beverages. Where I go to get my hair cut and colored. She has a mini fridge, and she has some, you know, kind of hard seltzers or little margaritas in there. So I always grab one in case I want to drink one. So it's kind of getting full, right? I do like to keep the milk here. And this one, I'm going to see if I can transfer it to one of my glass bottles. This, the boba needs to go. Here's some soy milk. And this is by, but you can see this is dirty. So I'm going to go ahead and wash and wipe this out. All right, these are washed and dried. I'm gonna put them back. And then I'm gonna put these drinks inside. I was able to decant this green tea into these bottles that I've had for a while. I'm glad I kept them. And if I can find the links from Amazon, I'll put it below. I'm pretty sure it's still there. And then these two bottles, they were kind of half full. One was like almost gone. So I was able to put them into two of these. So I have four of these total. Okay, so those can go to recycling. Then I'll put these away. I don't even know if they fit because I've... Oh, perfect. They fit perfectly in there. I'm going to put this by that I've been trying to finish forever here in the back. Okay, and like I said, I keep my milk here. It does keep well. I pretty much finish it in about a week. Week and a half, depending on how much coffee I'm drinking. I do have cereal once in a while. I like Honey Nut Cheerios. Let me know if you actually eat cereal. I didn't eat cereal for a long time. Okay, so that's that. And let me put the rest of the things that can fit from the igloo into here. Okay, we have these many cans. I went ahead and put the igloo to the backyard where we keep it. And what we do with that is we wash it before we use it. So right now I just had to put it, drain the water and just put it away. And the reason we do that is because we don't have to wash it twice. If I were to wash it now, when we go to use it again, we have to wash it again. So I just do it one time. And then all the bottled water will be going into my emergency water supply that you saw in my guest room. So I'm just gonna put these where they can fit. Let's see what can go in here. Okay, this area is all done. My Zoe's area, the snacks, the beverage cooler, as far as the recyclables. It was recycling day yesterday, so my husband usually takes care of that, so I'm sure the bin is empty. All right, the ice packs went into the garage freezer, and now I'm going to take care of this kitchen bar. This is the point where I have been filming now for 2.5 hours, and it starts to settle in, feeling like I haven't accomplished anything. But it's probably about an hour and 15 minutes worth of work. And I don't want to do the shuffling, but I am shuffling. And so some of these things, like the rags, I'm just going to go ahead and put them in the laundry room because I won't be using them. Then I'll be taking care of that, the rest of the stuff there. I think... Oh, The tablecloths are almost done. It's about a minute till they're fully dry, or I'll have to check first. But this is our ninja here, and my husband uses it for his daily shakes. So he kind of leaves it on the counter there. He should put a rag. So I just, it's already dry, so I can close it. And then as far as these dishes, I'm gonna go ahead and put them over here. So that's my cue to wash them. Okay, there's my orchid that I'm gonna keep there. I'm gonna let Zoe in. Hey, Zoe. And so that's pretty much clear. And I do like the this countertop to always be clear like that. What do you think? Should I, do you guys know how to take care of an orchid? Can you let me know? I mean, I feel bad because I get one every, like, honestly, probably once or twice a year, and I tell myself this time it's gonna last. But they literally, all the stuff, this just stays green. I wanna wipe the leaves. The leaves are a little bit dusty. Anyway, I just wiped this. This is water and some dishwashing liquid. This, what's that called? This is granite. But one day I will get to change out my kitchen, and I'm debating if it's quartz or granite. Definitely not marble. I can't afford that. But I found that a lot of my friends who are redoing their kitchen, they're doing granite. So this is our Berkey. So since I'm wiping over here, I'm just gonna wipe this down, put the rag there. Okay, that's good. All right, my poor lonely camelback sitting here. Gotta put her away. So I'm just gonna take the water that is still in here. I'm gonna water the plants and see what else is in here. Hi, Zoe. Since I'm here, I just wanna show you. Zoe, come here, come here, come here. Okay, so I do have a first aid kit here. I did put trail mix. Oh, I have, what's that called? Sunscreen, and that's the one you could put on your face. This is a little pocket. That's where I like to put my keys. This is actually a new bag, so I love it. I think it's called the Mule. I'll put in the link down, put in the description box below. Excuse me, Zoe. Excuse me. Excuse me. Come here. Come here. Okay. And then here. Okay. No, no, no. Zoe. Let me finish filming. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I have all these, like, tissue, body wipes, some mouthwash, because maybe sometimes straight from the trail you go out to a restaurant or something. Have some wipes here, feminine wipes, butt wipes, poopery, cleansing cloth, right? I mean, oil cloth for your face, deodorant wipe. I have a bunch of kits. I'll list them in the iCards or down below. This is a facial wipe. You know, so after a hike, you may not go straight home, but you may wanna go to a restaurant, let's say for brunch or something. And so I just have stuff for that. Oh, okay, yeah. And thank goodness I had a first aid kit, because our friend had a jumping cholla go on him. So I'll go ahead and put back this tweezers. Probably have to sanitize that, but anyway, for that for now, don't worry. Hopefully I'll remember. Yeah, then I had just have a little snack bag with trail mix. So since I'm just gonna hang this up in my command center, it usually goes in the garage, but we've just been keeping it there because we kind of like a visual cue to do more hiking, because I wanna do that. I'm just gonna leave the trail mix in there. Yeah, here's where I hang it. This is my command center area. And I'm just leaving the bladder open so it can dry some more. All right, recap. We got all the stuff in the hallway done. dog area, beverage cooler, camelback, this top kitchen bar area, and this is a little tin can. I put the label trash here. This is what I use for the coffee bar, so people can put, you know, the sugar packets, the stirrers in here. And then this goes to trash. This is what I'm drinking right now. Okay, and like I said earlier, my colleague gave me something. This is a body bar. This can be used for vegetables, so I'm gonna put that in my bag pod. She got me coffee. Here is Mexican chocolate and I guess some directions. So that's a Mexican chocolate. I'm gonna go ahead and put it back in here. So I'll definitely have this when it gets cooler. Guess what the temperature is today? It is 105. It got down to like 95 last week. So, you know, we always kind of celebrate that, but we know it's still gonna be hot till Halloween. Okay, so let me put all this away. And this was on the floor. Oh, by the way, as far as batteries, I have a little container that looks like a recycling bin from the Dollar Tree up in my office, my home office. I put the batteries there. When they get filled, I bring them to the battery recycling store. Okay, guys, I'm just wiping this down again with dishwashing liquid and water, warm water. But it becomes lukewarm quite quickly. All right, and it's already like 2:20. It's almost been 11, 12, almost been 3 hours since I started setting this up and preparing, or at least, you know, setting up the tripods and stuff. I mean, the lights and stuff. I'm going to go ahead and take a break right now. But before that, let me know, how's it going with your kitchen reset? Or did you pick another room that you're resetting? Are you just, you're watching, getting motivated, thinking about which room you want to do? Let me know in the comments below. How's it going, or which room you're going to do? And I'm gonna take a little break and come back.